ओके स्टार्ट करते हैं सर। आता
ओके सो तुम्ही बघताय ना जॉईंट से सगळे,
यस सर, यस।
तुम्ही जॉईन करताय मुलांना ना?
हो सर, बाकीचं तुम्ही फक्त लेक्चर द्या।
ओके जॉईन तुम्ही बघा, मी सुरू करतो आता। हां ओके स्टूडेंट्स, गुड आफ्टरनून। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इन द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कंजंक्टिवाइटिस, द इन्फेक्टिव कंजंक्टिवाइटिस। वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक इन द इन्फेक्टिव कंजंक्टिवाइटिस, वी डिस्कस अबाउट अक्यूट प्यूरुलेंट कंजंक्टिवाइटिस। नाउ व्हाट आर द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस चैप्टर? दैट स्टूडेंट्स बिफोर लर्निंग any chapter, any subjects, we should know what are the sign and symptoms of this purulent conjunctivitis and how to diagnose this condition, and also know what are the indication of homeopathic therapeutic drugs for this clinical condition of purulent conjunctivitis. Now as you see the slide full of purulent with the mixed with sometimes mucus, purulent conjunctivitis, it's a pus like trickling down from the eyes, conjunctiva, just bathed with the purulent pus, that is that you can see in this slide. Or you must be appreciating this slide. Now this is when its name suggests is acute conjunctivitis, where the discharge is frankly purulent. It occurs in two form. In adult, it occurs in the form of gonococcal conjunctivitis. In newborn, it is occur in the form of ophthalmia neonatorum. Now, what are the causes? When I say purulent conjunctivitis, always caused by gonorrhea, Neisseria gonococci. You see, adult are usually the sufferer of gonorrhea. Causative agent is Neisseria gonococci. How this mode of infection occurs, from genitalia, by direct contact, or metastatic infection from urethritis that leads to the conjunctiva and the conjunctiva get affect. In case of a doctor's nurse, by direct contact with the conjunctival discharge during examination of the patient, you can so this is a very simple mode of infection by the discharge entering your inner eye and you get affected. Now what are the pathology, students? Always when the gonococci enters into the by various means enter in your eyes, 24 hours after the infection, the gonococci forms a clusters on the surface of conjunctival epithelial cell, causes severe inflammation. Now this inflammation, within the next 2-3 days, the clusters increase in the numbers, the multiplication of bacteria occurs, and this the clusters of bacteria increases in numbers, and with this inflammation, superficial epithelial cell of conjunctiva begins to degenerate. Now when you find as a result this organism go in a deeper layer and may even reach to the subepithelial tissue, and because of this a very virulent organism causes edema of the subconjunctival tissue. Now the infection at the end of the first week, the epithelial cell regenerate from the basal layer. These regenerated cells actively phagocytose the organism. Now you have seen the pathology. Now what are the clinical course? Now when your patient comes to you, students, in your OPD, so there are first you can say there's a stage of infiltration, so entry of microorganisms and to the symptoms, stage of infiltration. Condition lasts for 4 to 5 days. So when these stages are there, patient will present with the pain and tenderness in the eye, and the conjunctiva appears bright red, velvety, or maybe chemosed. Chemosed meaning edematous. And initially, in a stage of infiltration, you will, students, you will find there's a watery discharge, not a purulent, initial stage, first 4 or 5 days. Then later on, exudation may coagulate on the surface of the conjunctiva to form a pseudomembrane. You must have seen the membrane, pseudomembranes deposits. Afterwards, this eyelids become densely swollen, painful. And always remember, students, whenever there's infective pathology anywhere, any parts of the body, the draining lymph nodes, that the preauricular glands are enlarged. Now, first stage, you have to stage an entry of bacteria and showing the symptoms. Now, next is the balanorrhea discharge. It starts from the 5th day, continuous discharge, frank, purulent, abundant, thick, creamy pus, drop down the cheeks. And very frank, I have shown you in the first slide, there's just, you can see the continuous purulent discharge coming out from the eyes. This is very, and followed by tenseness of the lid. Lid become very tense, very painful, tender. You will observe in this. Now, next stage comes because any infection, the natural course of disease, the final stage of maybe goes on healing. So pain, when the stage goes on healing, the pain become very much less, swelling of the lid subside, conjunctiva remains red, thick and velvety. The discharge slowly diminishes, but even at this stage, you can able to find out the gonococci in the discharge. Now, at the end, resolution is complete and chronic stage never attained. You will not find any chronicity in this acute purulent conjunctivitis caused by Neisseria gonococci. Now, students, you must understand this Neisseria gonococci is very, very infective. It infects the whole conjunctiva, thereby it also infects the cornea. So what will be the complication? Cornea, affection of cornea, there's edema of the corneal epithelium, definitely the edema of the layer, first layer, layer of cornea. So edema will occur of the corneal epithelium. Now, if the edema is not subside, if the immunity of the patient is very poor, then this edema may go lower down and may ulceration of the cornea, either central ulceration or in the central region, either you can find the marginal ulceration, you can observe in this. And slowly, this bacteria is very notorious bacteria. This Neisseria gonococci is only bacteria which penetrates the cornea. So there is a perforation of cornea will occur, and thereby corneal ulcer will perforation, sloughing may occur. Now, students, next you'll find the cornea, then iris. When the perforation occurs, so iris and iridocyclitis, inflammation inside the second layer, the iris along with there's a cyclitis, that is a choroid, also get affected with hypopyon. What is the meaning of hypopyon? Whenever there's some perforation occur, the anterior chamber collects pus and looks like a hypopyon. That is called as a hypopyon. Now, how do you diagnose this as a patient coming with this type of infective pathology caused by gonorrhea? Always adult male or female. I'm talking about adult type. I'm not talking about that is the ophthalmia neonatorum. History of gonococcal infection always you'll find either in the genital organs. Then inflammation of lid and conjunctiva. Patient always comes with a purulent discharge. Always when you go for any examination, gram negative, intracellular, diplococci on the smear examination can be observed. Now, student, what are the treatment? This, as I have told you, it is an infective type of conjunctivitis. So it can infect from one person to another. So prevent the infection from other eye and the eye of other member of the family. Always you should prevent it. So always the dressing to be destroyed. Towel and linens used by the patient to be kept separate. In the case of accidental infection of eyes to the doctor and nurse, you always, they are handling infections so that immediately ask the patient silver nitrate solution. One person has to be instilled in the eye, followed by a broad spectrum antibiotics. So these are the prophylactic measures to prevent the infection of unaffected eye and infected to the family and or doctors. Now, what are the local treatment? Now, students, as the Neisseria gonococca is susceptible to penicillin, you can prevent a frequent drop of penicillin lotion. And along with the, if, because frequent broad spectrum antibiotic ointment may be applied at the time, bedtime, because what will happen, sometime because of purulent discharge, your eyelids stick together. So if you apply this antibiotics, sticking of the eyelid can be prevented. If the corneal ulcer develops, atropine sulfate, 1% ointment should be applied at a bedtime. These are the local treatment. Now students, already we know it is systemic infection. If this patient is having the suffering from gonorrhea, the systemic treatment with the penicillin injection should be given so that patient will not reinfect his conjunctiva or even not infect to other. Now, when you have students study, what are the discharge? Now you can say, I've told you a purulent mucopurulent discharge. So whenever you have got a drug, you can think of a Merxol, you think of a Calisulf, you have Pulsatilla, Argent Nitricum, and Heparsulf. Now students, Merxol, very patients worse at night. Other conditions of severe infections, purulent discharge, ulceration, it can observe very painful with a complication like iritis, iridocyclitis, you can see in Merxol. Calisulf, you can see the discharge is similar to Pulsatilla, like bland discharge, Lewis discharge, and if Pulsatilla fails, you can think Calisulf as a remedy for purulent conjunctivitis. Argent Nitricum, again, you can find the purulent discharge with severe pain, ulceration, cannot look at a bright light, photophobia, all these symptoms are present in Argent Nitricum, you can prescribe. Now, Heparsulf, very sensitive patient, and hypersensitive, purulent discharge, and sensitive to cold, that you can find Heparsulf for the totality of homeopathic management. These are the basic remedy you can study, and you can always examine in exam these questions ask. Now, what we have studied till now? Students, we have discussed about the definition of conjunctivitis. We have discussed about the causes, pathology. We have discussed clinical stages. We have discussed complication, corneal complication, iridocyclitis complications, and we have discussed management. We have talked about homeopathic therapeutics. Now, what are the summary of this chapter? Now, I have told you, first learning objective was to know the sign and symptoms of conjunctivitis. So always a painful condition with a purulent discharge. On examination, we'll finding papillary velvety appearance of conjunctiva. Papillary elevated, congested, engorgement that you find in conjunctiva. So this is a diagnosis by papillary velvety appearance conjunctiva on examination. Now to know the indication of Pulsatilla, always use a bland discharge. Merxol, you sense pain worse at night. Argent Nitricum is the best remedy for children as well in adult. Heparsulf, we can find, I told you, hypopyon and ulceration of the cornea. So these are the important summarization which you must learn, students. Now, students, what are the questions can be asked for 2 marks? Sometimes, tell me, question asked so far, only organism which can penetrate the cornea, that is Neisseria gonococci. 5 months question, describe the acute purulent conjunctivitis, give indication of Pulsatilla and Heparsulf in purulent conjunctivitis. These are 2 questions was asked. Now, next topic in the same, there's ophthalmia neonatorum. Now children, how the children are suffering from this type of purulent conjunctivitis that caused by Neisseria gonococci. Now in the children name has been changed, the condition is called ophthalmia neonatorum. Now in this, what are the learning objective? Again student, whenever anything, to know the sign and symptoms of ophthalmia neonatorum. to study the differential diagnosis of child with discharge from eye within the first month of life, to study the mode of presentation and differential diagnosis. Now, see the ophthalmia neonatorum child, how much difficult the eyes are closed, difficult to remove. Sometimes if this child's are spasms in the eyes, eyelids, and it's very difficult to open the eye. Sometimes to open the eye, we require retractor, right? But we have to open very carefully. Now, what do you understand by this ophthalmia neonatorum? Students, it is always bilateral, purulent conjunctivitis occurring in newborn within the first month of life. Students, never diagnose ophthalmia neonatorum beyond first month of life. It's a very preventable disease, students, but even though we cannot prevent preventable disease occurring in a newborn child due to maternal infection acquired the time of birth. So maternal infections, you can prevent it. You can prevent the by good hygiene, good practice, by giving a treating with the mother, and so the infection will not pass to the baby or children or infants. So students, so it's very important, responsible for 50% blindness among children. So this is a very, very dangerous situation occurring. If the mother is suffering from infection, so that passing to the infants and infants, 50% blindness may occur in children. So you can treat it. Now, who are more people who are sufferer from the disease? Prevalent with poor hygiene and limited access to proper health care. Students, definitely the hygiene is not maintained properly and they don't get a proper health care. Student, this is a very important dictum. Any discharge, even a watery discharge, watery secretion from a baby's eye during the first 3 weeks to 1 month should be always observed, seen with suspicion. Even since tears are not secreted so early in the life, students, first 3 weeks to 1 month, even tears are not at all secreted, because lacrimal gland does not well develop. But if you find any discharge, whatsoever may be, in the first week or first 3 to 4 weeks, you always think there are some problem. What are the problem? The problem may be the DD of a child with the discharge from the eye within the first month of life includes, students, the baby have congenital block nasolacrimal duct. Baby has acute dacrocystitis. And baby has congenital glaucoma. You must understand this. If these three things are there in the first 3 weeks, you must always appreciate that she is having this problem. Now, what are the cause? As the name suggests, purulent conjunctivitis, children's ophthalmia neonatorum, always gonococci, pneumococci, staphylococci, aureus, and staphylococcus hemolyticus. Now, what are the mode of, why the mode of infection? The eye may be infected in two ways. During birth, this is the commonest. After birth, during birth is very, very common, because infected genital organs, the baby may suffer. After birth, from soil, linen gets soiled with the bacteria and the baby may get infected. Now, what are the clinical features, students, you must appreciate? Always and always within the first 48 hours of any discharge, purulent discharge coming out, if the baby will get a first 48 hours, anything comes, always diagnose that is caused by gonococci and Neisseria. Discharge purulent, mucopurulent, followed by purulent. Both eyes are always affected. Conjunctiva, always I have showed, is intensely inflamed, bright red, and solid with a thick yellow pus discharge. Is a marked chemosis. Students, when you're going to examine this eye, baby's eye, eye is full of packed, and so you use a retractor. Retractors might be needed to separate the swollen lid, student. But while removing, you surgeon must wear, or doctor, physician must wear protective goggles. because in the discharge may instill your eyes. So that is very, very important things which you have to understand here. Now, on examination, students, because I told you it affects the cornea, it crater like pit on a cornea, means khadda, small type of pit you will observe in the cornea. You can see dense infiltration of the bulbar conjunctiva. Lids are swollen and tense. Conjunctiva looks puckered and velvety. Puckered means kichawa, that's like coming, congested, puckered, velvet, velvety, engorgement of blood vessels, velvety. So this reaction of conjunctiva can be observed. Now, what are the complications, students? Always, if not treated properly, the students always, the infants will reach to the corneal ulceration, and if not treated, perforation in untreated gonococcal ophthalmia neonatorum, perforation occur of cornea. Now, what are the investigations, students? Investigations, you can have a conjunctival smear for culture and sensitivity test. Always, you can see the Neisseria gonococci and you can see that is important. Now, students, how the mode of presentation, differential diagnosis with the mode of presentation. Now, whenever the time of onset after birth, if within the first 48 hours, you'll get any discharge, first 48 hours, always diagnose Neisseria gonococci or accidentally some chemical has been instilled in the baby's eye. Two things always remember, either because of chemical, the baby's eye get conjunctivitis or Neisseria gonorrhea. You will differentiate it both. If it is beyond 48 hours, children's baby getting infection, getting discharged beyond from 48 hours to 78 hours, always think it is other bacteria, not Neisseria gonococci. If it is coming, if it again the baby coming from the from 5 to 7 days, if at all discharge from coming from 5 to 7 days, it is not Neisseria, it is not chemical, it is not other bacteria, it is herpes simplex virus, students. So these DD is very important. If the symptom starts, if the discharge, any discharge more than 1 week, always and always think of Chlamydia trachomatis. Chlamydia trachomatis. Again, remember, students. So differential time of onset after birth, remember, first 48 hours, Neisseria, 48 hours to 78 hours, other bacteria, from 5 to 7 days, herpes simplex virus, more than 1 week, Chlamydia trachomatis. This is very important things we have to understand by this. Now, what are the treatments? Now, what are the treatments? Is a preventable disease, so prophylactic treatment is of a prime importance. Any suspicious vaginal discharge during ANC should be treated. Always prophylactic, you must always, antenatal care must be taken care. If the patient have any discharge, you must assume that there's a Neisseria gonococci, you must treat vigorously. Otherwise, infection will pass to the baby while delivery. So always you follow meticulous obstetric aseptic precaution must be maintained at birth. Newborn baby's eyelid should be thoroughly washed with sterile cotton, cleaned with sterile cotton, soaked in a sterile normal saline. So these are the very important treatment you have to. Now, what we do if the mother is suspected to be infected with the gonococci? Already you know the mother is suspected with the gonococci infection. Then you must use 1% tetracycline or azithromycin ointment to the baby. The eye must be carefully washed or followed. Babies, the infant's eye must be carefully washed during the first week. Follow-up must be carefully taken. See that there is no complication occurs. Now, what we have discussed, definition, always bilateral affections, always both sides, purulent discharge, so edema, painful, so that you can find the definition of that is ophthalmia, always children, the first week, first 3 to 1 month, 3 weeks to 1 month baby suffer from ophthalmia neonatorum. Causes, always I have, what are the causes? I told you caused by Neisseria gonococci, Staphylococcus aureus, and other pneumococcus, other bacteria can cause this type of infection. Now, clinical features, most clinical features are mucopurulent, purulent discharge, with edema, with pain, with what is called a spasm. So all these features you must observe. Complication, always I have told you, is ulcerations. There's a complications, corneal ulceration you can observe. Differential diagnosis, I have told you. I have told you two types of differential, according to the onset, mode of onset, and according to other. If the first 3 weeks, 3 to 4 weeks, baby, because already I know, in the first 3 to 4 weeks, baby's lacrimal gland is not well developed, so baby does not have any discharge. If the baby come with some discharge, you must always think of, there is a congenital blockage. You must think of nasolacrimal duct, congenital blockage of nasolacrimal duct. Then you must think of congenital glaucoma. You must also think for the, what is called as the congenital glaucoma. So these are the another way, and another way differential diagnosis was by the discharge, which the mode of presentation, ophthalmia neonatorum, you can find first 48 hours. What you have discussed, if the patient come with the first 48 hours, you must always think that is Neisseria gonococci or anything, even not no Neisseria, then you must think of chemical. Now, the treatment. What the treatment? Treatment is preventive treatment as well as curative treatment. Preventive treatment you have seen, that is by preventing the infection to the eye. Curative treatment, you are instilling the eye drops, antibiotic eye drops, and this. Now, what are the homeopathic medicine? Now, the homeopathic drugs, which I have told you, Merck salt, Heparcel, Pulsatilla, all these Argentum nitricum, all these remedies are also useful in this ophthalmia neonatorum. Heparcel, I have told you about the corneal ulceration with hypopyon. What is hypopyon? Hypopyon meaning there is a anterior, there is a chamber, there is an accumulation of fluid, exudate, and that looks like a hypopyon because of the iris, get exudates and complications in the further corneal ulcer, you will observe hypopyon. So this is a treatment. Now, what are the summary? So always, whenever there is a ophthalmia neonatorum, is a very painful condition, always children's, infants, 3 to 4 weeks infants are the sufferer, and always condition purulent discharge will present, and that you must diagnose. To study the differential, I have already told you, congenital blocked nasolacrimal duct, acute decorocystitis, and congenital glaucoma. I have told you the mode of presentation. Already I have told you mode of presentation. This is the mode of presentation, time of onset after birth. If it is within the first 48 hours, you always remember Neisseria gonorrhea, chemical from first 48 hour to 78 hours, other bacteria from 5 to 7 days, herpes simplex virus, more than 1 week, chlamydia, trachomatis. So these are the things which you have understood. Now, so sometimes the question can be asked like this, name differential diagnosis of a child with discharge from I within the first month of I. What are these differential diagnoses? I have told you already the answers already given. That is congenital blocked nasolacrimal duct, acute decrocystitis, and congenital. This question you must always ask. Students, remember this can be asked. Now, sometimes the mode of presentation the question can be asked. Next, describe ophthalmia neonatorum. Always and always question can be asked for 5 marks. So already its notes are there. You can see. Give indication of urgent nitricum in ophthalmia neonatorum. Or the silver nitrate solution I have told you. Already people are using AgNO3 1% drop to treat the infection. So thank you. So today we have discussed about the infective conjunctivitis. In that infective conjunctivitis, purulent with the mucopurulent purulent conjunctivitis in adult and in infants. Adult we have discussed caused by Neisseria, and in infants there is ophthalmia neonatorum. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
Sir, झाले का लेक्चर?
हाँ झाले.
Okay, okay. मी क्लोज करतो सर.
Okay. Thank you. आता तुम्ही काय करता? क्विट मी इकडनं तुम्ही करता की मी करू?
नाही नाही मी करतो.
Okay.
Okay.